And then step number five, measure everything. And then I've said apply Kaizen, which in the presence of Colin from Toyota, obviously don't claim to have the expertise and the depth of knowledge that they have, but I think that the idea of Kaizen is that you try to improve everything continuously. And I'm sure there's a much wider and deeper definition. And for that, you need to measure everything you do. So every time you've done a campaign, you say, okay, what can we learn from that campaign? Sit together with your team and say, what can we do to improve things, even if it's a tiny improvement? And it's really this incremental improvement that's critical. Because if you don't do that, what you see is the same mistakes being repeated over and over again. And the fact that things change all the time on the web isn't an excuse, because you can really learn from the very simple things by implementing them systematically. Step number six, really important for people in international companies, remember about politics. This is not just about doing a really successful campaign, it's also about getting the right people in the organization to understand that. And often senior management will not understand what you're talking about when you say we're doing a Facebook campaign or a blog or a Twitter. So you need to think, okay, how will I not only do this, but also get that to be understood by the people who can either make this happen or stop it? And I've seen a lot of campaigns taking place in international organizations where they were very successful, but they just didn't resonate because nobody at senior management felt interested, or they just thought, oh, this is some technology geeks doing it. So it's really important to understand, how do I use that in my own positioning? How do I bring that to senior management so that at least they don't oppose it? And if not, they support it. And step number seven, you need to bring down those silos. The modern organization, the international company, is really built around silos still to this day. And the web is really the force that breaks these silos apart, whether you like it or not. So by embracing web projects, you actually start challenging structures. You have to talk to people in different departments. You have to get in touch with people in product, sales, marketing, PR, etc. And you need to start challenging the silos, whether they're regional, countrywide, etc., because the web touches on everyone at every level. So you have to bring about that new thinking. And that's, I think, the biggest challenge that a corporate communicator faces. Now, you all recognize this celebrity. The web gives you the opportunity to become extraordinarily famous. Now, I'm not actually advocating that you all start singing and try to emulate Susan Boyle's success. But what I mean is that you can actually be successful in building your own brand. Tom Peters talks a lot about brand you. And what I'm talking about here is that you can use very simple tools like blogs, like Twitter, like LinkedIn, which most people are using already, to build your network. And in these uncertain times, this is really critical, because nobody knows what's going to happen in the next 6 months, year. All the preconceptions that some companies are, you know, too big to fail are gone. So you need to build your own network and your reputation inside the organization and then beyond it. And the web gives you the tools to do that. And finally, I think that we're at a really exciting time in the communication world. I've been hoping for the last 10 years to see this dramatic shift, and I actually think that now we're beginning to really see it. Not just a shift in budgets, not just a shift in hype, but actually a structural shift where the old model of marketing starts drifting away and a new one has to replace it. But that new model still has to be built. We don't know what it looks like, and it's up to us as communicators to invent it. So for those of you who want to take up that challenge, it's a fascinating time, because you can actually invent this future.